Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial of MQTT. In this tutorial we will cover the following points. First we will look into introduction, in which I will cover a brief history of MQTT. After that we will see the overview of MQTT, why you need MQTT, and then we will see the MQTT message transfer architecture. After that we will discuss about the MQTT packet forwarding. So if you search in the internet, you will see everyone is explaining MQTT full form as a message queuing telemetry transport protocol, which is not true. So I will explain you in detail. MQTT protocol was invented in 1999 by Andy Stanford Clark, which is working for IBM, and Arlene Nepal. They needed a protocol for minimal battery loss and minimal bandwidth to connect with oil pipelines via satellite. So this is their requirement, this challenge they are facing for connection of oil pipelines via satellite. So these two inventors specified several requirements for future protocol. So their requirement is like this: whatever protocol they will going to design, it will be simple implementation, quality of service, data delivery, authentication, reliability will be there, and that protocol should be lightweight and bandwidth efficient. Lightweight means that doesn't involve any hardcore programming. So by using light programming and light tools, they will also save some bandwidth and make their protocol as efficient as required. Data agnostic, continuous session awareness. So these goals are the core concept of MQTT. However, the primary focus of the protocol has changed from proprietary embedded system to open internets of thing use cases. There is a separate video of Internet of Thing. You can check that also. This shift in focus has created a lot of confusion about what the acronym MQTT stands for. The short answer is that MQTT is no longer considered an acronym. MQTT is simply the name of the protocol. It means what I mentioned earlier, there is right now there will be no full form of MQTT, means it will be created for some other stuff, but right now it become a standard protocol with the name itself MQTT. The longer answer is that the former acronym is stood for MQTT telemetry transform. MQTT referred to the MQ series, a product IBM developed to support MQ telemetry transport. When Andy and Arlene created their protocol in 1999, they named it after the IBM product. Many sources label MQTT incorrectly as a message queue protocol. That is simply not true. So you see, as I mentioned earlier, MQTT is not a traditional message queuing solution, although it is possible to queue message in certain cases. Over the next 10 years, IBM used the protocol internally until they released MQTT 3.1 version as a royalty-free version in 2010. Since then, everyone is welcoming to implement and use the protocol. Now, MQTT is an open source protocol which are used in wide variety of applications in Internet of Things domain. So why we need MQTT? So these are the core concept of MQTT, why we need this another kind of protocol. See, MQTT is lightweight and efficient. MQTT clients are very small, require minimal resources, so can be used on a small microcontroller. As I mentioned earlier, it will require minimal hardware and minimal lightweight software programming. MQTT message headers are small to optimize network bandwidth. It's a MQTT is a bi-directional communication. MQTT allows for messaging between device to cloud and cloud to devices. This makes for easy broadcasting message to group of things. Scale to million of things. MQTT can scale to connect with million of IoT devices. Another feature is reliable message delivery. Reliability of message delivery is important for many IoT use cases. This is why MQTT has three defined quality of service level: 0 at most one, 1 at least one, 2 exactly ones. Support for unreliable network. Many IoT devices connect over unreliable cellular network. MQTT support for persistent session reduce the time to reconnect the client with the broker. MQTT security enable. MQTT make it easy to encrypt message using TLS and authenticate client using modern authentication protocols such as OAuth. So you will getting all this assurance if you're going to use MQTT in your application. Moving to more deep in the MQTT overview. MQTT is an OSI's standard messaging protocol for the Internet of Things. It is designed as an extremely lightweight publish-subscribe messaging transport that is ideal for connecting remote devices with a small code footprint and minimal network bandwidth. As I mentioned earlier, it will require very lightweight programming where you can quickly do your programming and connect and send all your data packet as per your requirement. MQTT today is used in a wide variety of industries such as automotive, manufacturing, telecommunication, oil and gas, etc. And it is one of the most desirable protocol for using IoT industries. Some of the features of MQTT are use of publish subscribe message pattern. We will discuss in later slide what are publish and what are subscribe message pattern, which provide one to many message distribution and decoupling of application. A messaging transport that is agnostic to the content of the payload. Three quality of service of message delivery. At most once, one is at most one, second one is at least one, and third one is with exactly one. So what is at most once? At most once means message are delivered accordingly to the best effort of the operating environment. Message loss can occur. This level could be used, for example, with ambient sensor data, where it does not matter if an individual reading is lost, as the next one will be published soon after. It depends on the requirement. What type of service you required while sending or exchanging data between client and server. In at least one category where messages are assured to arrive but duplicates can occur. And in exactly once where messages are assured to arrive exactly once means whatever you send will receive at the server side exactly once. This level could be used, for example, with billing system where duplicate or lost message could lead to incorrect charges billing, because these are the critical system in financial sectors and billing. Correct message should be delivered once and it should be authenticated. So in that scenario, this exactly once quality of service will be very helpful. After that, a small transfer overhead and protocol exchanges minimized to reduce network traffic, which is also very good features of this MQTT protocol. A mechanism to notify interested parties when an abnormal disconnection occurs. So this is the, as you see, this is the basic MQTT publish subscribe architecture, where you have MQTT client, MQTT broker, and MQTT server or MQTT client. So this temperature sensor is the publisher, means it sends the temperature of any particular region, suppose agricultural farmland or any tank, chemical temperature or water temperature or any liquid temperature. So it will publish these temperature data over the MQTT. So it will publish 24 degree centigrade data and it will publish to top temperature. In similar way, MQTT client, suppose mobile devices, you can subscribe to this topic which will subscribe to publish topic to get the sensor data in your handheld mobile device. That is temperature will be, suppose in this example is 24 degrees centigrade. In the similar way, you can subscribe as many topic as you want, and the subscriber is one to many or many to one. Architecture is there, so it's more like a DTH or television broadcasting type of architecture, where the broadcaster already broadcast their channel data, and you have to, when you turn on your TV and you tune into a particular channel, then it will, your TV receiver will catch that signal channel frequency and it will broadcast to your television screen. So in same way, MQTT work as a MQTT publish and subscribe architecture. Sensor will publish their data through MQTT broker, and all the subscribers who are already subscribed to that topic will receive that sensor data at their respective. So I hope you all have understand what this public subscribe architecture is. So when we send data, every time MQTT packet is divided into three parts are there in MQTT packet. One is fixed header, that there is a variable header, and payload. Payload is nothing but the ultimate data you want to send to the server or client. Next header will contain the command for the activity what you want to perform. So for your base and basic understanding, in a very simple way, I will divide this MQTT packet sending in three parts. One is connect, second one is publish, and third one is subscribe. So you have to connect, publish, and subscribe. So if you move going to in detail for this MQTT packet, then there is a MQTT version 5.0 specification PDF is available in MQTT portal. I will provide that link in my description. You can look. So whatever MQTT architecture you are going to perform, this video is very helpful in your message exchange. I mentioned earlier, MQTT packet consists of three parts. One is fixed header, variable header, and payload. So this one, if you see this one, this first we check for connect packet. In connect control packet, MQTT control packet, which first one is the connect connection address. What does it mean? After a network connection established by a client to a server, the first packet sent from client to the server must be a connect packet. So first you have to send the connect packet. And how this connect packet look like? Now this fixed header come into the picture which I mentioned earlier. So whatever packet you send, it consists of fixed header, variable header, and a payload. So for fixed header, which is basically a 2-byte address, where in first byte you have to provide what activity you want to perform. Suppose in this case we are connecting this message. So for connect, this command is this. You have to set this bit as 1. So if you convert this bit into decimal, then it will get the value as 16. So you have to set 16 value in this byte 1, and byte 2 will contain the remaining length of the total packet minus the
instead of. After this, you have to add protocol name in your message packet. In under protocol name, you have to provide first the protocol length. After that, the protocol name. In this case, protocol name is MQTT, which is a forward address. So they will provide the length as 4. This section is a UTF-8 encoded string. So you have to provide this as a string type data type. Every detail of packet, what bit specification and what are the activity, that bit is mentioned in detail in this specification PDF. So this PDF will be very handy for your MQTT or understanding the MQTT message packet. After that, you have to add the protocol version in your message type. So in this case, the version is 5 because we are using MQTT version 5, which is the latest one. So if this is the binary, this is the binary bit, if you convert this one, then it will convert it to decimal 5. So after that, you have to add the connect flag. Under this connect flag, which is a 1 byte address, is 8 bit. So 8 bit have different functionality, whatever your requirement. You have to, if you have to authenticate your message, then you will say you have to set this username flag as 1 and password flag as 1. And what are the function of this single every bit is given below. See, in clean start, if a connect packet is, if you want to use this clean start function, then you have to set the clean start bit as 1. What does it mean? If a connect packet is received with clean start and set to 1, the client and server must discard any existing session and start a new session. In similar way, wheel flag details are given below. QoS is detailed. QoS is also mentioned, which I also already mentioned earlier. Then username and password. And then you have to add keep alive, which is also a 2 byte address, which consists of the time for which it will hold the connection. Like keep alive is a 2 byte integer, which is a time interval measure in 7. The maximum time interval that is permitted to allow the finishes transmitting one MQTT control packet. Means after sending one MQTT control packet, the connection will disconnect. So for that, if you want to retain that connection for a specified duration of time, then you have to provide this keep alive in number of seconds. Client it starts sending the next. It is responsibility of the client to ensure that the interval between MQTT control packet being sent does not exceed the keep alive value. So this you have to maintain while sending the packet. So moving. So these are the detail of the. After that, you have to provide the property length and then your payload will follow. So here in PDF they also provide a how your connect packet will look like as per the our description. See, first they will, after the connect fixed header, you have to add this protocol name. These and these are the binary values for this respective string value. After that, you have to provide the protocol version, then connect flag. In connect flag, you have to set the respective feature you want to use, either you have to authenticate or you want to freshly start after every iteration. So accordingly, you have to set this bit as 1. After that, you have to provide the keep alive. So this value represents the duration of time interval 10 seconds. If you want a time interval of 10 seconds, then you have to set this bit as 1. After that, your length and the payload will follow. payload which the term payload is used in MQTT, which means the ultimate data I want to send over. The architecture between server and thing. So after this connect, you have to publish. Go to the publish. Yeah, it's also follow the same architecture, but in publish the control fixed header bit is different, which is 3. So you have to set this 2 bit as 1 to achieve this published fixed header. The value, you have to set this value as per your requirement. What does it mean? Is this driver? What does QoS mean? So QoS, as I mentioned earlier, it's a quality of service which is you have to set 2 for exactly 1 delivery. Then what the return will do. These are the description of every bit. In published case, we have to provide a topic name via that topic name your data will publish. So in this case they are providing example using this format. I will show you. So these are the public packet variable. First you have to provide the topic name. So the topic name is A by B, which is a 3-byte address, 3-byte name, string format. So they will first provide the length 3. If you have another topic name, then you have to calculate its length and then provide the topic name. And these are the corresponding string and ASCII hex value. After that, you have to add the packet identifier and the property name. After that, your published payload will follow. After published payload, you have to provide the QoS. You have to add the QoS at the end of your published packet, which is very important for publishing packet. You will get all detail in this PDF. Now moving to the subscribe packet. Subscribe request fixed header part is also a 2-byte address where its decimal value you have to set is 8. So you have to set this bit as 1. These bits are reserved for future use. And byte 2 is also similar like the previous one. You have to provide the remaining length of your message packet. And after that, you have to provide the subscriber variable header and payload. In this case, topic filter will come into existence. Topic filter is nothing but whatever topic you created to publish that message, the same where these servers are or user end devices will be connected to that or subscribe to that topic to get that data in their end. This is the subscribe packet data format, which is first you have to provide the topic filter. Similarly, you have to provide the length, like A by B is the topic filter. So, length is 3, so you have to provide it. Here is the example, it shows you two type different type of filter they are going to use. So, it depends on your requirement. For a single, you can use one topic name and one topic filter, and accordingly your message will be published at the client or server and it will be subscribed, so that data will seem successful. So in this PDF we will define a detailed description of everything, what are the error will come and what are the function of every bit. So it will be very helpful for you. So this come to the end of this MQTT tutorial. So I hope you have now an overview of MQTT, what MQTT is, and what are the message packet for MQTT. So this is MQTT connection. MQTT protocol is based on TCP/IP. So both the client and broker need to have a TCP/IP. So if you see the OSI layer 3, which will contain the IP, and layer 4 will contain the TCP and layer 5 to 7 where application are there and their MQTT come into existence. The MQTT connection is always between one client and the broker. Client has connect to each other directly. To initiate a connection, the client side sends a connect message to the broker. The broker responds with a connection acknowledgement message and a status code. Once the connection is established, the broker keeps it open until the client sends a disconnect command or the connection breaks. Thank you, everyone.